this is how you play water tag?
Heck yeah, it is. Isn't this fun?
Meh, a little cliche.
You say that about every game.
You know what else I say about everything?
Oh, please don't.
Never mind. You know the drill.
You know something? Every time you don't say it, it's actually worse.
And that's why I think it's awesome.
Sweet God. I'm gonna go check on Morwenna before I lose more of my sanity. Hey, ladies.
Ladies?
That's what you are. Everything all right in here? We're kind of missing you in there.
I don't know.
Oh, go have fun. We both know how much you love swimming.
I mean, all right, if you're sure. Have fun tanning, Aggie.
Does tanning do anything for you?
Eh, not really, but the sun feels nice.
Makes sense. Don't burn, all right?
Oh my gosh, don't worry. I put sunscreen on already. I'm not gonna turn this into an anime and do it here.
Good call. But will you be all right by yourself?
Don't worry. I can keep her company. I mean, that's okay.
Rena? Oh, hey. I didn't think you were coming today.
I almost didn't. Darren had a pissy fit about it. But I decided you guys were important.
Better late than never.
Huh?
Nothing. I'm gonna go back in the ocean. I gotta get water tag to finish.
Wait. Darren didn't want you here?
Well, he found out boys would be here and, you know.
Girl, that doesn't sound healthy at all.
Don't worry, it's just because he loves me.
Yeah, I don't think that...
Oh, hey! Morwenna's on fire right now!
Oh my god, someone go help her!
Wait, I didn't mean it like that.
How am I supposed to tag you?
You're too slow!
I hate this.
So, how are things with Julius?
Good. We slept in the same room.
Ooh, I wish me and Darren could sleep in the same room.
It's cool, but he does snore sometimes.
Yeah, I've had sleepovers with him before. Over the top of his nose, and if he sneezes once, you're in the clear. Listen, now that I have the chance to say this alone, I'm sorry about your brother.
Hey, I understand. Sorry about what he did to you. To all of you, really.
I have a constant reminder of his deeds every time I look in the mirror. Funny, really. I wanted to be just like Morwenna, but now I understand how she feels all the time and every day.
At least she's not alone anymore. That's gonna be important going into high school.
Oh yeah! Gosh, can't they keep school closed a little longer?
Yeah, it's already bad enough. At least we got a chance to mend things now.
Yeah. Let's hope so.
Apart, and I don't know what I'm heading into.
High school. And what should I do in Illyria? Not sound too much like a nerd on the first day, that's what.
Okay, nobody said anything yet. Just keep walking. Pretend there's nothing wrong. You've done this before. Why are you trembling, legs? Well, come on, Morwenna. Grow some thicker skin, or scales, or whatever.
Hey there, I saw you looking around. Are you lost?
Maybe a little, but that's not it.
That's quite an accessory you got there. Bold choice wearing that on your first day.
It's not an accessory, it's real.
What? No way. That's so cool. Were you bored with it?
I got it when I was 5. I don't want to talk about it.
Okay. So, can you crush boulders with it?
Dude!
Sorry, I couldn't help myself. I'm Kevin. I'm in the mentor program. Let me show you around.
Okay.
One second.
Which way are you gonna go? Come on, feel around a little.
Bianca?
You know her?
Unfortunately, she was at my first middle school. Looks like she hasn't changed much.
Speak for yourself. Looks like you still haven't had that, operation. Serves me right for looking out for you.
You're doing plenty of looking out already by the looks of things.
Huh? Oh, you mean her? Nah, she's an old friend. We just wanted to give her a little welcoming embrace.
Yeah, well... Looks like she had enough fun for now. You do have plenty of time to catch up later.
Why is that, Draco? Will your father hear about this?
Maybe. Go ahead. Flip that coin.
The more things change, the more they stay the same.
Morwenna! Thank goodness.
Aggie, I'm so glad you're okay. And this is Kevin.
Thanks a lot for helping me back there.
You're welcome, but I'm over here. Oh.
Hey, if someone needs a guide, it's definitely us. Hey, Aggie, what homeroom did you get?
It's room... 131.
Dang it! I'm 137!
Oh, those are down the corridor. I'll leave you ladies to it from here. I gotta go see if there are any more stragglers to help out. Let's hope they're as cute as a pair of you two.
Hey, does he know that...
No, just follow me. Alright, there's your homeroom. Walk straight ahead for about 10 paces. I'm guessing the teacher's in there.
Probably. Okay, see you later. Best of luck.
Same to you. We've got this.
No way.
Oh my gosh, Pete, this is unbelievable.
Yep, what a stroke of luck. I get my two favorite people every morning.
Wait, two favorite people? That means...
Would you excuse me, please?
have to do that on our first day.
You didn't stop me. You're adorable. I've missed you.
You missed you too.
Guys, we'd better claim our seats. The teacher's probably out to call order.
I wonder what kind of teacher we'll get. Wonder if it's another ball of energy like Mrs. Dysart.
Hello, students! My name is Mrs. Littlewit, and I'm going to be your homeroom teacher. Today I will teach you... nothing. So sit down and don't be too loud. Back in the day, my dad would throw a book at me if I was too loud. Nowadays, that's not allowed. So I'll give you a straight talking to, Sonny. Now I'm going to take a nap and wait for death to finally claim me. Okay, I'm supposed to stay awake and watch you all hooligans. But then again, I'm 93 years old. I need a nap. Good night, children.
Are we ever going to get a normal teacher?
We traded high Miss Frizzle for this.
Okay. What classes do you have?
Hello, students! My name is Coach Morales, and I'm here to help you get all buff like me. Buff!
Have you noticed that every teacher here is?
Yes!
Let me start by saying that this class will not adhere to the stereotype set out for high school PE experience. That being said, today we'll be playing dodgeball. It is why I'm so buff. JK, lol. Now, you play it by avoiding balls. Now get ready to be hit with balls. Buff.
Shouldn't we pick our teams first?
I mean, I don't know. I mean, yeah! You could be one of the team captains. And you, lady in the front. You could be the other one.
Heck yeah, my time to shine. Not you, not you, not you, you. Not you, not you. You'll do, I guess. You, 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 and you.
That's not how I usually pick the team. Let's roll with it. You all know the rules.
Coach Morales, can I see you?
Sure, bro.
I will destroy you, Dragon Girl.
We'll see.
I'm back! I hope I didn't interrupt something intense. Anyways, ready, set, fight! Go. Go. Go is what I meant.
You weren't that good after all.
Looks like you're not on the ball today.
That was a terrible pun.
But not inaccurate.
Shut up.
Dang. Get me some of that later.
Gotcha, babe!
I guess this works too. Curse my hubris.
Meh. Julius, no! Wait, who's left?
Prepare to get what's coming to you. If I remember one thing from middle school, it's that you can't dodge.
Oof. And the winning team is... Team with that girl on it! Yeah! Alright, I'll see you all at the club booths later today. We've got more dodgeball, athletics, baseball, and... what's the other one? Oh yeah, swimming! Hope to see you there.
I mean, I've seen some epic plays in my time, but I never expected Mawena to turn that girl into a Scott Sternly tribute.
Sounds like she just got her desserts.
I mean, I didn't mean to do it, but it still felt amazing.
Well, baseball trials are over there.
Julius!
Nah, that would never work. Besides, we all know her sporting prowess lies in different waters. What? I saw how much fun you had at the beach, and this could be a fresh start for you.
Ooh, fresh start. I get it.
I wasn't making a pun.
Are you sure about that?
Here we go.
Aw, don't be so salty about it.
Ugh, Agatha, what do you see in this guy?
His dry sense of humor.
I'm so proud of you.
So, anyways, swim team, come on.
It's been too long.
It's been 5 days.
You know what I mean. Besides, they kicked me out before because of
performance-enhancing tail. Yes, you know. But hey, new school, new rules. Besides, pretty sure Coach Morales supervises all the clubs. You're in his good books now.
Fine. If it'll get you guys off my back, I'll go ask them. But believe me, they're gonna take one look at me and say,
sure.
Wait, what?
Awesome.
Yes.
So you guys have no problem.
Are you free on Wednesdays and Fridays to train?
Well, yes, but...
Then there's no problem, is there? Right, guys?
Wait, so this is a mixed swimming team then?
Yep, they used to split every sport into boys and girls, but the education department suddenly went, huh, this is stupid, it's the 21st century, and here we are.
What about stuff like football?
Oh, there are still a few people iffy about that, but there's a simple DSU solution for that.
DSU?
Don't sign up.
Wait, weren't we gonna go sign up for theater together?
Just put my name down.
Wait, were you planning to join as well?
Well, yeah, I know I was doubtful about it last year, but since it was so much more fun, I decided to give it a go. After all, the past is in the past, right? I like what I like. Okay, fine. I walked into that one, didn't I? Give me the sign-up sheet.
Okay, let's sign up together.
I'd like that. Do you want to join, Agatha?
Why not? I need something to do to, you know, not get bored.
That really sounds like what Raina said last year. Where is she anyway?
Cheerleading squad? I thought she'd be playing volleyball.
Yeah, I was thinking of doing that, but I was also considering cheerleading in the back of my head. Plus, Aaron said he's always wanted to date a cheerleader.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Huh?
Question, are you doing this for you or for him?
Does it matter?
Well, yes.
Then I'm doing it for both of us.
Okay.
Hey, don't worry. I'll still be at your matches. I just won't be playing, that's all.
I guess.
Welcome to the 2020 cheerleading tryouts. You all know who I am, and pretty sure the team will know all of you. Are you all ready? Oh my goodness, that was terrible. You'll have to show much more enthusiasm than that to get in.
Heck yeah, Coach! We're ready! Woohoo!
I believe we have a volunteer to go first! Your name was Roan, right?
It's Raina.
Right. Well, in your own time. Don't really like your manners. I live in insanity. I don't think you've ever been a fan of me. No, never ever. You keep trying to play a director. And I don't want to cause a scene. Every time you're out of line, I want to scream. So despicable. Overcritical. You undermine. Leave me wondering why I keep you all these nights. All these lonely nights. All this precious time.
my god. Yes, Queen Slay!
Excellent, Reyna! And thank you, Greg. Well, you set the bar high. Who's gonna be brave enough to follow up that?
I will. Now, hit my music! Alright. A one, a two, a one, two, three. For real? How did I not get in the team? What is wrong with the coach?
Forget it, Pop. You know, I bet only real bimbos could put in the team.
Yeah, totally. Like, totally bimbos. Yeah.
Whatever.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
We should go into science class.
Yeah.
It's so great that we're in a class together.
Yeah, but I'm not really good at science. I'm more of an English guy.
Yeah, Mrs. Dysart hyped you up quite a lot in our class, but now it's my time to shine. My father worked for Laboration Tech, so science is in my blood.
Yeah, but I wish you weren't sharing with them.
Do you think this would taste like strawberries or cherries?
Well, the teacher did say not to drink any chemicals he gave us.
But didn't he say that this made, like, water or something?
Yes, but the mixture is not perfect. The thing to always remember about science, there is always room for error.
Ah! I got a hydraulic acid on my shirt.
For example...
Science in the blood, eh?
But I'm still learning.
Whatever you say.
I've always imagined that a high school science class would consist of mixing two liquids together like in TV shows. I just didn't imagine it would be literally the first lesson.
I just realized something. We point out cliches a lot all the time. Do you think at this point pointing out cliches is becoming a cliche of its own?
Well... if it is, you've pointed out the cliché of us pointing out clichés, and I suppose I just pointed out the cliché of you pointing out the cliché that we-
Stop! Stop, please! You're gonna kill my brain like that!
Julius, I need your help. Hey, which one is the hydrochloric acid and which one is the sodium hydroxide?
Acid on the right, hydroxide on the left. Here, let's mix. Okay, as for the pH stuff, I put the universal indicator in before. The acid turned red, and the sodium hydroxide turned blue. So the pH is of 2 and 14, respectively. And now, the indicator has gone green in the mixture, meaning it's a pH of 7, which, according to the chart, is...
neutral!
Wow, is that what Marwick and I look like to you guys?
Yep.
Oof, sorry.
Hey, I get it now, trust me. I'm the same around Darren.
I can imagine you are, cheerleader.
Alright. I tried out without my hat on, you know?
Really?
Yeah, I figured if they wanted me on the team, I wanted it to be with them knowing all of me. I need to live with what I did.
Why bring the hat at all?
I think maybe I'm just not fully used to it yet. I'll get there, I promise.
Do you remember when Mrs. Dysart told us the story of King Midas?
The Golden Touch guy?
Yes, but I mean the other Midas story.
King Midas had a really fine encounter after the Golden Touch one. It happened when he was called to judge a lyre competition between two gods. Does anyone know which two?
I'm guessing Apollo and Hermes?
Not quite. Though Hermes did invent the lyre, Pan took it up and challenged Apollo at one point. What's more, Midas deemed him the superior musician. And so, Apollo transformed his ears into those of a donkey, reflecting his opinion that Midas had donkey ears to not realize he was the best.
There's another bit about the king's barber being the only one to see him, and how revealed the secret such and such, and it's not important. The point is that the secret literally weighed him down for the rest of his life, all because he kept it to himself instead of owning what happened.
Wait, didn't he just give his opinion?
Okay, the motives aren't exactly airtight, but you get where I'm going, right? You are owning the choice you made, for better or worse.
So I'm doing the right thing then?
First time for everything.
Hey! Okay, fine. I deserved that. So, can you forgive me yet?
I'm getting there. I was furious at first, but looks like you're suffering enough. You've proven you're sorry.
Thanks. I'm glad to still have friends like you. Come on, let's finish this thing. But I feel-